You sure this is how you want to play this?
Last thing they're going to expect is an attack from the water. You head back round to the row. Stay with the car. I'll meet you over there when this is done.
Hope you know what you're doing.
Trust me, Ellis. Here in a bit, this will all be behind us.
How many men we send in?
Two teams. One's gonna hit the bar, the other's going up. The Perlis. Boss says if we have to burn down half the hollow to get to Sammy, we're doing it. Ain't stopping till that old man is dead.
Him, Ellis, and the other one.
Lincoln Clay.
He's the one. This time he won't get away from us.
Got something.
Right, motherfucker.
Saw something suspicious.
This is getting goddamn ridiculous.
No excuses! Tear this place apart!
I'll put one in his ear!
Oh, no!
Oh, shit! I'm taking cover!
Where you going, Capon?
Over here!
Put one in his ear!
Oh my God!
Wait, your people, Capsaga!
Made a big mistake going after the Hollow.
No, this one I play easy. Coward! Wait up! Look, man, nothing's up to white now.
The man you're talking about took me in when I had nowhere else to go.
You are no better than him.
You can't take those souls! You fucking pig! Damn you to her!
Take it easy!
Take it easy! Take it easy! He kept me in there, locked in there, day and night. Beat me, used me. I killed you, motherfucker! You and your entire goddamn family!
He's dead! He's dead! He can't hurt you anymore. It's over.
Over. Over. This is never going to be over. Pajam!
Fucking Haitians.
Seriously? What the fuck are you doing?
Sammy's boy is in there!
Okay, yeah. You'll die!
I won't stop shooting!
Give me a hat! Can't move for him firing! We at the crossroads, Busan! Shit in here! Can't move for him firing! Ah!
fuck him up.
He's coming this way.
Don't think about it. Shoot him. Let's watch him burn.
Oh, my God, something. Tear your limb from me.
Got me.
He stayed dead, not let him. Let's get back to Sammy's.
Can't even tell you how happy Pops is gonna be. And this shit with the Haitians has been weighing on him.
With them out the way, things will calm down. They're back to the way they should be.
Been telling him for months we needed to do something like this, but Pops, he... I don't know. Sometimes I think he's lost the taste for this shit.
Just because a man don't rush to violence don't mean he lost something.
I know, just makes me wonder what happens after. You know?
No, I don't know. Explain it to me.
Don't matter if it's a bullet or the hand of God. We all go sometime, right?
I suppose. Ellis, we don't need to talk about
it. I pray that Pops outlives the both of us. But if he doesn't, every motherfucker in the Hollow's gonna be looking to us or gunning for us. Just saying we gotta be ready when that day comes.
Yeah, well, that's not something we gotta worry about right now. So just cool it with your grand plans, all right?
Yeah, all right.
Hilarious.
1450 WNBX.
The thing Lincoln didn't understand, or maybe want to understand, is that for a man like Sammy, there's always gonna be more Haitians. Now, if there wasn't someone going after Sammy, then there was someone else forcing him into a bad situation. It was never going to end. That's how Lincoln ended up working for Sal Marcano.
You were right about those Haitians being down by that old salt mine. They won't be bothering us again.
It was a mistake sending you down there. I should handle my own business.
This isn't any different than what I was doing before I left.
You probably don't know this, but every night on the TV, right after the news, they show the names of all the boys killed over there in Vietnam. I'd be sitting in the kitchen eating my supper, watching that list scroll by, wondering if today is the day I finally see your name.
But you never did. Nothing happened to me.
There's only so much luck down the well. Sooner or later, pull up that bucket, there's nothing in it.
So, what are we gonna do about Marcano?
Pay him his goddamn money one way or the other.
Lottery gonna be enough to cover it?
The lottery? No. But Sal called a bit ago. Wants you to meet him up the country club. Says he's got something in the works. Square things up between us.
The only black folk allowed in there to help.
Now, they may not like it, but they're not gonna say no to Sal Marcano. He says you get to come in, you get to come in.
Fine. I always did want to see the inside of that place.
You need to do whatever Sal asks, yeah? For all our sakes.
Yes, sir.
Native Son! Welcome back to Native Son, dear listener. Fuel on the fire today. Thankfully, my producer, Gilbert. Oh, thank you, Gilbert. He's kind enough to bring me in a full thermos of coffee from downtown's own tasty patisserie. Just hits the spot. You all out there know what I'm talking about. Yes, you do. Oh, and Nancy wants me to remind you. Tasty patisserie. Now, you tell her Remy sent you, and it's buy two, get one free. Can't beat that. So go on over there and tell her I sent you. I know. I'm not supposed to enjoy my coffee on air. Oh, Gilbert's turning red, folks. Oh, I tell you, we like to have our fun, dear listener. And that's what Mardi Gras is going to be all about. Good old-fashioned New Bordeaux F-U-E. And if I sound a little enthusiastic, well, I'm sorry about it. But I am. I've talked before about being honored to be part of the crew of knights for the 10th year running. We got a heck of a float plan for y'all, and we have spared no expense in strutting our stuff. Now, this will be my first crew since my dad died last year. Dear listener, you know how important Mardi Gras was to him. God rest his soul, he was one of the crew of knights' founders. He was captain for more years. Back in 1932, for those of you whose memories go all the way back then. Oh, you know, I more than anything else, it was the tradition, the feeling of being part of something, of this city that he loved so. My father believed that every man had his role to play, and every role contributed to the greater whole. Because there's only one.
Russia. Even the ones here at home, they try to sell that as equality. No, sir. There's always going to be a king. And each king has his day. I'll tell you, that coffee sure is fine. On the next episode, you better believe we're going to talk about this here story that President Johnson is considering a deal with the Russians.
All units, scale back on repeat, repeat abandoned search. Return to patrol.
That, I'm right here. Native Son.
You doing up here? Help goes into the back.
I'm here to see Mr. Marcano. The name's Lincoln Clay.
That a fact? I'll be goddamned. Mind your manners while you're in there, boy, or there'll be hell to pay, you hear? Park over to the side.
Lincoln Clay! Christ, man, get a look at you! I bet those fucking gooks shit themselves when they saw you coming.
Been a long time, Georgie.
Oh, no shit, it's been a long time. I think the last time I saw you was that night over in the French ward, right before you shipped out. Damn, but that wasn't a gas.
Oh, I seem to remember me and Ellis running from the cops. And Danny ending up in the drunk tank.
Hell, man, I bailed him out. Besides, it was worth it to knock the hell out of them cracker assholes. Smoke?
Sure.
Oh, man.
Sammy said Mr. Marcano wanted to see me.
Mr. Marcano? Shit. Make him sound like a goddamn lawyer. You just call him Sal. Come on, he's in the back.
I should have wore something else.
Hey, these squares have a problem with your threads. Take it up with my old man. He'll tell him to kiss his ass. Nice thing about having fuck you money.
Olivia, I hate to cut this short, darling, but I've got a meeting coming up. Remy, a pleasure as always, sir. Two more glasses.
Lincoln, good to see you. This is Vito Scaletta. He's the one I've been telling you about. Come on, Lincoln, sit down.
So you served in Vietnam, huh?
Yes, sir.
Sal tells me you earned a few pieces of tin over there.
Well, I served with some good men. Nothing I did would happen without them.
Army? Marines?
Regular Army at first, and then I was recruited to the 5th SFG.
Special Forces.
I told you it was something else. Now, not that anything's gonna go wrong, but just in case, goddamn, don't you want a man like that on your side?
Well, if you're vouching for him, Sal, that's good enough for me. Look, I got a couple things to take care of. Thanks for the drink.
Christ, that guy's an asshole. Fucking carpetbagger. Commission sent him down here from Empire Bay about 15 years back. He's been a pain in my goddamn ass ever since. Well, I guess you're wondering what this is all about.
Yeah, Sammy didn't tell me too much.
Twice a year, the feds take old money out of circulation and destroy it. Over the course of the next few days, that money's gonna be delivered here to the reserve in town.
And you're gonna hit one of those shipments?
No, sir. We are gonna use that occasion to gain access to their vault.
And then steal everything that ain't nailed down. Should be $6-7 million in there, easy.
That's pretty fucking ballsy.
It's a chance of a goddamn lifetime is what it is.
Now, Vito's fronting a lot of the money for the job, and he got us the combination to the vault. Hey, you had a chance to see Danny?
No, not yet.
Oh, well, you will. We brought him and his old man in on this, and they're gonna need your help, so go see them. They're still in that same place.
There's something else we gotta talk about. Now, safe to assume you know about the problem Sammy's been having.
I took care of the Haitians. Once things settle down, money will start coming in again.
You see that right there? That's what I'm talking about. You didn't sit around with your thumb jammed in your ass. You saw a problem, you went out and took care of it. Goddamn, I'd take that over money any day of the week.
We pay our own way, debts and all. Always have.
Oh, hell, son, I know that. I wouldn't expect otherwise. But you know, even after we all evened up, you're still gonna be slopping around in the ass end of this city. Not much of a future in that. But maybe there's a different way forward, you understand? For all of us.
What'd you have in mind?
I want you to know I mean no disrespect when I say this. Sammy's a hell of a man, but he's not getting any younger. And I'm thinking it's time to make a change.
Well, I don't think that Ellis is ready for that kind of...
I'm not talking about Ellis. I'm talking about you. I want you to run the holler.
I can't do that.
Well, look here. If you're worried about Sammy, don't you understand? Now, he's always been on the level with me. And this job we're talking about, there's more than enough for him to retire on.
He took me in when I had nowhere else to go. Treated me like a son. I'm sorry, Mr. Marcano. I can't do that to him.
Well, shit, son. I'd be lying if I didn't say I wasn't just a little disappointed. But I get it. You're loyal, which is something that is scarce these days.
Do you still want me to help with this thing we've been talking about?
You goddamn right I do! And when it's all done, you all be more than square with me. You have my word.
What do you really want to hear? That we'd kidnap and torture anyone suspected of working with the VC? I'm trying to ascertain the level of training that Lincoln Clay received during his time in Vietnam. Someone like that you don't need to train. You point them in the right direction, you get the fuck out of their way.